My money goes straight to that stash box. Become a bad bitch. Bread on my sandwich. Been young and reckless, I swear, cause I'm still in the hood. We throw metal like cannons. I'm on the train of my bastards. Talk about this act on these bastards. I would react over caskets. Who won't react over caskets? If I don't get killed over rap shit, my linen gon' be Louis Fabric. Saying that I'm gon' be lavish. I'm doing the beat and I'm out of control. If it ain't convenient, your product is old. The fire be young till he's out of his soul. These bitches is feeling a parry. You think you can do that, I'm out of control. Stop on that whole energy. That's not my way to reach. If I knew what I knew in the past, I would have been the whole family moosh. I'm aware I'm a god. When it comes to this music, can't compare me to y'all. Confusion. Frauds in the room, shit. I'm about to tune shit. These niggas ain't doing shit. These bitches ain't doing shit. These bitches ain't fucking. But dirt's getting moved with a dustpan.
Genesis and holds a lot of meaning for a lot of different people. Chapter 16, verse 8. And the angel said unto him, "You there, slave boy, where have you come from and where are you going to?" The man replied, "I'm running away from my cruel and abusive master." The angel of the Lord said to him, "Go back to your master and submit to ill treatment at his hands." And so, Mr. Bird returned. And to Mr. Wilde, thanks be to God.
Boys, staff. Lots of announcements today, so please do listen carefully. This week's King's Lecture will be given by Rohan Browning on internet safety. Boys are advised to try to get, very hard to get there for you. Some Lost Property announcements now. Could Max Crawler please come and collect his school tie from Lost Property? Although, only if he has time, since we know he's often tied down with other things. A pair of Alex Hartley's shoes have been left over from last year. Tom Hartley, although you may not be able to fill them, can you please come back? A message for James Johnson. Can you please stay behind after this assembly for another year? Christian Union meets today at 1:15, where Mr. Meadowcroft will be giving a talk entitled "When I Set That Bush on Fire," which will follow on from last week's talk, "When I Killed Every Firstborn Child in Egypt." Photography Society meets on Wednesday, where Mr. Bird will be teaching students night vision photography. Attendees should meet outside Mr. Wilde's house at midnight. Bring your cameras, leave your dignity. A general studies announcement. For students doing childcare, the toddler will be present on Tuesday. Students are advised to handle Mr. White with great care. Economic Society meets this week, where you and Middleton will be giving a talk entitled, Of Course I Bank. Unfortunately, it doesn't look like we're going to be getting a snow day anytime soon, although we will soon be getting a new school captain, so the RGS is due to be whiter than it's ever been. And finally, boys are reminded that baguettes will be served today instead of normal lunch. In the light of this, your emergency Sainsbury's exits will be located here, here, and here. Thank you.
Sports results. Chess. We played Hampton. We won 6.5, 5.5, whatever the hell that means. House fencing today. Bring your hammers and nails. The RGS competed in a cross-country event last weekend. George Gathercole came first. Gus Cockle came second. No, not really, George. A special announcement now. George Halen this last week competed in the under-15 weightlifting competition over the weekend. Now, George, where are you? Stand up so we can see. There you are. Oh, fantastic. Oh, George, it says here that you came last. No, don't sit down. Yeah, feel free to point and laugh, everyone. George, I guess, well, maybe if you spent as much time weightlifting as you do styling your hair, you would have done a bit better. And lastly, a message for Mr. Seaman. Sorry, Seymour.
After a year of Oxbridge results bordering on the historic, Mr. Dunscombe peruses the talent on offer for the following year.
Morning, guys!
Hi, sir.
How are you?
You're in a really good mood today, sir.
Well, wouldn't you be with these Oxbridge results?
Hey, a fantastic year, Mr. Dunscombe. Great work. Have you turned your mind to next year's cohort yet?
Yes. Have you considered the lower sixth?
The lower sixth?
Sorry, but you're right.
Is something wrong?
Something wrong. Something wrong.
Something wrong. No oxygen. No, not PPE. P.E. Don't do P.E.
Right, that's it.
You're not leaving, are you, sir? The lower sixth, they need you.
What? You think you can stop me? Pin, you didn't have the balls to go for Oxford. Calvin, you're too stupid to even get into Oxford. George, I'm not going to take a second opinion from someone who is so used to coming second. Loser! And you, whatever your name is.
His name's Jack.
Yeah, Jill. Don't bother looking at me. I'm off!
And now, from the team that brought you The Wizard of Dodd, The Dark Mr. Knight Rises, and Breaking Bod.
Let's cook.
It's the RGS Hunger Games.
Thank you.
In the absence of Mr. Dunscombe's firm and steady disciplinary hand, the prefects have been forced to adapt to a sudden influx of opportunistic miscreants.
What's wrong with Matt?
You kidding? Dunscombe leaving the crime wave? He's done things, man. Two folders today alone. That kind of blood just doesn't wash off.
Jesus. Do you think we should say something? Anything?
And say what? People are scared, can't you see it? You say the wrong thing, make someone nervous. Well, he might put you in folded. Just out of instinct. This place, this position, it does things to you. You either die a sick former, or you live long enough to see yourself become a prefect.
Why don't we put ourselves in full bit then, huh? Just to make the pain stop.
We can't let them win.
You're both too soft. That's the problem.
Don't. Leave him be.
Where were you? Where were you in the lunch queue revolt of last week, huh? That's real action, real justice.
A massacre!
A massacre.
24 full bits.
That is what this place has come to.
No, you're wrong, Seb.
You're wrong!
Guys, come quick! It's bad! Oh God, it's bad!
What have we got?
I was standing here. I was just doing my job. I told him it wasn't 1 o'clock yet. I told him! He just pushed straight past me. I never even saw his face.
We'll get to the bottom of this, Tristan.
What have we got?
Footprints. Size 11, maybe 12.
My God.
What is it?
Fingerprints! Get these to FO1 now! Get these prints to the database now! Where are you?
Do we have a match?
But I'm just checking the database!
No. It can't be!
Oh no. No, no!
It doesn't have to be this way, Seb.
Doesn't it? This whole place has fallen into anarchy. Only makes sense if we do too.
You won't get away with this!
I already have. Fooled it.
No! Tristan!
You're crazy, Seb.
Am I?
Or just ahead of a curve?
Sebastian Morton, I'm placing you in...
Fooled it.
Jack! Jack, no! Jack, Flynn!
Avenge me.
Sam!
Seb, you are such a drama queen.
In recent weeks, a vigilante has appeared at Bradston Brook. Accused of stealing all of the fans, he goes only by the title of Bradstone Raider.
You got no fans? You got no crowd?
Righty, Beckingham's playing well.
You want some? I'll give it to you. You want some? You want to deal with me?
I'm the Bradstone Raider. You might know who I am. I've got all the fans. Saxton got no fans. Wiggins got no tunes.
Mm-hmm.
And now, history with Rupert Fitzsimmons.
Yes! Today a startling discovery has been made in the last part of the school's 1500s original building, the G Corridor Toilets. Yes! Every part of it oozes tulip class. From the 1960s Bruceless tiling to the artist Jack's ceramic sinks. But earlier today, archaeologists discovered something quite remarkable here on the toilet walls. A picture, a symbol that can only have been drawn by Sir Robert of Beckenham himself. A message from the school's founder to the pupils of today. It's an elegant design, but it appears to have been drawn in an undecipherable code. What is it? Nobody knows. But what we do know, it is beautiful. This is Rupert Fitzsimmons, over and out.
Okay, so guys, we're going to be talking about the divine right of kings today. This was the belief explored by James the First.
Wade Barrett looking to put on to the table. Looking to drop the
Hi, Will. It's Mr. Williams, Deputy Head.
Yes, sir. I know who you are.
Great. Hey, Will. I'm just wondering, how's the Charity Day Assembly going?
Yeah, really great, actually. You know, we've got Calvin ready for...
Fantastic. Hey, Will, I was just wondering, I think it'd be great, really fantastic for the boys, if at the end of every sketch, we had the credits. Who's been involved, who's written it, who's filmed it. It would be great for the boys. It would really make a difference for them.
Sorry, credits? At the end of each sketch?
Yeah, absolutely.
So let's just imagine something crazy, that this conversation, Mr. Williams, that we're having right now actually was a Charity Day sketch. And if that were a Charity Day sketch, we'd put credits at the end, right?
Yeah, it'd be great for the boys, Will. Can you imagine?
At the end of each and every sketch?
Yeah, it'd be great. You know, we can make a real difference, because you know, the kids these days, we just need inspiration. And I think by putting the credits at the end of every single sketch, I can be Mr. Inspiration. You know, Will, I think I can change lives.
And Mr. Williams, you're sure this won't make the assembly a bit long?
No.
Look at Randy Orton slithering.
Oh, watch,
like
out, watch, out, watch out, watch out, watch out, watch out! Oh, the man nowhere!
Good morning, boys. Mr. Bridges has given me some alternative teaching techniques and we'll be trying them out in today's lesson. Orton talks in poem 8 about the frogs exhaling from the pond. You've got to be the frog. Oops.
Look at Randy Orton slithering.
Oh, watch out, watch out, watch out, watch out, watch
out, watch out, watch out, watch out, watch out, watch out, Dodd, tu le mens pour les hommes. 75% des.
Hello, it's your friendly PE teacher and occasional first form English teacher, Mr. Shaw, here to sell you a new product. Yes, it's Shaw for Men. Ooh, look at that power. Shaw for Men can be used in every occasion. And yes, I mean every occasion. Parties, weddings, funerals, bar mitzvahs, bat mitzvahs, Shrove Tuesday, Ash Wednesday, Good Friday, Easter Monday, Mother's Day, Father's Day, Parents or Guardians Day, and much, much more. And yes, I mean even more, for that first full discotheque. before general studies. Or on that sweaty cricket tour to Sri Lanka, when you want to cover up those sweaty patches. Yes, I'm looking at you, Jonathan French. And if you don't believe me, listen to the words of an actual customer. Yes, an actual customer.
Hi, it's me, an ugly, a fine shuffling, but now everybody loves me.
That was Janice from Milton Keynes. Come visit me to pick up a copy of your show for men in the PE cupboard, in the PE cupboard, in the sports hall. Now priced at only $12.99.
Miss Shaw cannot be held accountable for any damage caused by
Show for men,
including but not limited to death, blindness, some limb loss, spontaneous combustion, condition of heart, results may vary.
Miss Williams, can I borrow a stapler, please?
No.
Tonight, I come on, yeah, I get down tonight, uh-huh, everybody get down, down tonight, yeah. Come on.
Chess club, there ain't no party like a chess club party, everybody get down tonight, chess club, there ain't no party like a chess club party, oh, everybody from side to side, throw your rumps in the air, like you just don't care. There's an issue over here. There's a knight over there.
Kumar's doing his dance. Jennings plays with advance. Dad's doing good on the board. While Timmy screams out for more. Wanna see Charlie swing. Wanna see Harry do his thing. Then we got horn
stealing dead boards.
Get ready everybody, cause
here we go.
Yes, no.
There ain't no fun like the test of a lord.
Bring it down to the lord.
Lovely weather, Cowie.
Look, Ben, it's coming
to
for you.
To the point, and now we're going to... Oh, my!
Look!
Oh!
Right, guys, the inspectors are here. Let's make this a great lesson. Come on. Okay, there's Charles I. He's being executed. Okay, we just need that final letter. Come on, what is it? Will? Will? Max? Jake? Johnny? Come on, you can do it. What's the last letter? It's an I! Mark? Mr. Hoskins, is it really you?
No, sir. My name's Jake.
I'm so sorry. Yeah, Calvin, just wondered, I mean, who do you reckon would be the best school captain next year?
Perfectly honest, sir, I don't think any of them are any good. You should probably just appoint me again.
Mr. Hoskins? Mr. Hoskins? Is it really you?
Mr. Williams, how many times do I have to say this? Mr. Hoskins gone. He's not here. He's never coming back. You have to get over this. We've said this before.
Mr. Woodman, I was just wondering, would you be able to wear this mask? It just reminds me of the old days, when Mr. Hoskins used to be sitting on the other side of this desk.
I'm sorry, Mr. Williams. Mr. Hoskins is gone. It's a new F1 partnership, a new duo.
I'd really like it if you just wear the mask, Mr. Woodman, please.
Mr. Williams, I'm sorry. I've told you many times before, I'm not wearing that mask.
Yeah, just picking up where we left off a few minutes ago, just wondering if you've got any ideas about the lunch key. I mean, we've tried being nice to the boys. We've tried out-and-out aggression.
Move! Now! But look, it's World War III! I am a prefect!
But nothing seems to work. Water cannon. Fantastic. What a brilliant idea, Mr. Hoskins. I'm so glad you're still here.
It's gone too far. I think I found a solution. I'm going to partition off part of my office.
What are you calling it?
I'm going to call it Adrian's Wall.
Gentlemen, I'm so glad we've come to this arrangement. It's fantastic. It's perfect. Well, Mr. Hoskins, shall we begin?
Yes, Mr. Hoskins.
Somebody! Can anyone hear me? Help!
So Dunstan, you're back?
Yeah, I've just gone for another Starbucks. Other coffee providers are available.
So, what about the lower sixth?
Now listen, lower sixth. The upper sixth made me say it. Remember, you've got fantastic Oxbridge potential. I've been looking through the list. I mean, there's the Barmels, the Osborne twins, the Barmels, the Osborne twins, and of course, apart from Oxbridge, there are lots of other universities available, like Bournemouth, Sunderland, Lincoln, Teesside, South Bank Polytechnic.
Night, night, Calvin. See you in the morning.
Hello, Garth. It's me. I'm sorry I've had to use a video to try and get through to you, but you know, I'm a big fan of yours, but please, you've got to stop following me. You can't keep wandering around Reeds at night. You can't just stare through my window and watching television. Come on. We've had a great time, and I know, well, Mr. Woodman, he tries. I know it's difficult. I know it's tough. But look, please stop following me. And it's only next weekend that we're going paintballing together. We love that, don't we? So I look forward to spending some time with you there. Okay, bye-bye.
Yes, love. Get down tonight, come on, yeah. Get down tonight, uh-huh. Everybody get down tonight,
yeah. Come on. Chess club. There ain't no party like a chess club party. Everybody get down tonight. Chess club. There ain't no party like a chess club party.
I feed the pigeons, I sometimes feed the sparrows too. It gives me an enormous sense of well-being.
I know a certain Mr. Jenkins who teaches at a certain grammar school in the south of England, say no more, say no more. And this Mr. Jenkins, he's known me for quite a while. Do you know what he says to me?
Nah.
He comes up to me and he says, Sam, I need you to record a song for me. I says, I can do that. What kind of theme are you looking for? He says, I'm looking for Best of British. So I said, yeah, I think what you need is a parody band. Didn't I say that?
Yeah.
So I said, what you need is a parody band. And I said, I've got this great band lined up. I know them. They've been performing in Guildford for quite a while. They're called Radness. They're a parody of Madness, a ska punk band. I said, so what house are you in? What house are you in? Do you know what house he's in?
Nah.
I said, what house are you in? He said, I'm in Nettles. And I said, oh, you're lucky, sir. That's the best house in the school. Ain't it the best house in the school?
Yeah.
So then I record this track and I hopes you like it.
Downstairs, our lack of points makes us weep. Calvin's got a day to keep, he can't hang around. Our house, in the middle of big school. Our house, in the middle of our house, it has a crowd. There's always something happening, and it's usually quite loud. Gas is running, makes us proud. Nothing ever slows him down, and second place is not allowed. Our house, in the middle of Guildford. Our house, in the middle of our house, in the middle of big school. Our house, in the middle of our. Timmy turns on liquid chess. First years really try their best, but they never.
Get some exercise.
Reach for the moon, reach far as I can go. them in. We've actually got one better. We've got our own breakfast, bed, and lunch. Got to come forward, guys.
Six brilliant videos, well done to all, everyone who was involved. And before me, I'm glad I wasn't in there anyway. I've stopped sweating, luckily. I have an envelope. In the envelope, the runners up and the winners, the winning prize will be awarded at final assembly, I've been told. So well done, everybody. Winners decided then by Breakfast Bev at Eagle Radio, which is true, even though we had our own Breakfast Bev. The runners up, a big hand please for Powell. You will be receiving official Eagle Radio merchandise. And the winners of the house video, and I'm sure you give a great hand please, they were all brilliant videos of course and good fun. The winners this year of House Music Video 2015 are Nettle. So just to complete the assembly, we're now going through to period two in a moment, will be released by Heads of the Age. So final thanks to all those involved in House videos, and particularly a final round of applause to the Upper Six for a fantastic assembly.
Welcome to Start Soon now. Hopefully it'll be a good one. Yeah, we're about to kick off. Boys and boys, it's welcome to Staff Sumo. It's a classic charity event where you get to see your most beloved members of the staff waddling around in beach folk sumo suits in a sport that's almost as old as Mr. Saxton.
So before we get started, let's introduce our referee for the afternoon to make sure the fights are kept clean and keeping everything in order. The formidable Scotsman and everyone's favourite replacement deputy head is Mr. Lund.
Before we get started, I'll quickly run you through the rules. So there'll be two fighters, both dressed in sumo suits. First fighter, three points wins. Get 1 point for knocking your opponent onto their back. Another point for knocking your opponent off the ring with 2 feet off the ring. And Mr. Woodman's law is final, and he is able to make the fighters go through any pre-match preparations that he sees fit. So, straight on to our first fight. We have two of the school's big guns going head to head. Some say he's climbed a mountain higher than Everest. Was it that he's so manly that he's taught his body never to sleep? All we know is it's Mr. Schimmel!
Fox, the PE department. He's the director of sport. No one really knows what that means. And I'm off. Well done, Al.
Thank you.
Go! Go! Go!
Go! your wits. How'd you feel that went?
Yeah, good. I feel like totally owned him.
You benefited from being the only returning sumo wrestler.
Oh, definitely. It's all about technique.
What do you describe your technique?
Smash him hard.
Ladies and gentlemen, your champion, Mr. Wits! Fighting action whilst enjoy some of the RGS's top quality entertainment. It's everyone a favourite senior prefect versus the one boy you can't miss in the senior prefect rap battle.
Senior prefect rap battle between Tim Chess King Foster and Calvin, you know who I am, right up.
Thank you.
show your day, how you feel? How you feel? Run to the semis, run to the final?
All I do is win.
Okay, Mr. Gattle!
So now it's time for our final fight, qualifying for semi-finals. And we really have saved the best till last. Coming all the way from the history department, made his wrestling debut, possibly the most intelligent man in the school. We don't get to have said that. It's Mr. Wiggins! He's so convinced he's Spanish, he insists on his friends and family calling him Señor. It's Mr.
Banishing bandana trick, okay?
I don't know if any of you have heard of that. Hope not. But anyway, if we... You want to begin? Yeah, sure. Okay. So, there we go. What we've got here is set of instructions. Okay, we'll go with that. Still with me, yeah? So we've got a set of instructions here. Ms. Williams, I asked you to... Is that your mic? You bring along your yellow bandana. Have you got that?
Yeah, you did, Tom, yeah. I had a few problems with that. I last wore it in my gap year in South America. I can't find it. I'm really sorry. I know you needed the yellow bandana, but I couldn't find it. I'm really sorry, Tom.
Okay,
sorry to let you down.
What have you got instead?
Well, you know, I thought you said yellow, you said bandana. I thought something yellow, something that sounds like bandana. So I thought yellow banana.
I guess
that wasn't a trick, by the way.
might make this a bit more difficult than.
That's right, we're magicians.
Anyway,
we can do this.
We'll see what the instruction says. So, well, step one, it says we do need the square fabric. We've got there.
Brilliant, fantastic.
And we did need the yellow bandana, but
that's again, we've got the banana. We'll be alright. We'll be okay.
Now, software says you've got to take the bandana. We'll pretend that this is the bandana.
Bandana.
Okay.
The bandana.
And fold it in half.
Okay.
There you go. Okay. It then says to fold it in half again.
Okay, it's fine.
Good. Okay. And then what we've got to practice here is this thing called palming. I don't know if anyone.
I know palming.
You know palming.
I'm a magician. I know about palming.
Okay, show me how it's done.
Okay, palming. So what you do is you want to show the audience that you've got nothing in your left hand by palming, by covering it up like that. Okay, it's nothing there. It's fine.
Yeah, I guess.
That's palming.
That's going to happen. That's
palming.
That's going to happen. That's palming. We'll go with that. Okay,
fine.
So just keep it there for a minute.
Keep it there. Natural position.
Yeah, I think we'll start the trick properly now. So, first of all, what you're going to do is open up the folded bandana.
Okay, open up. There we go.
You might open up a bit more.
Yeah, fine.
Now, you're going to show the audience that it's a regular bandana by waving it up and down. So, okay.
It's a regular bandana.
Now, this is it. If an audience member does not believe it is a real bandana, it says allow them to wipe their face on it. So,
where's the school captain? So where's that green? There we go.
What we're going to do now, we're going to take the fabric apparently.
Okay, good fabric.
Take the fabric, and we've got to gather the four corners and make a makeshift bag. Okay, so I'll give that a go.
Go for it.
One, two, three, and four. Now the next step, using your free hand, fold the bandana along the creases you made earlier.
Okay, fold the bandana. Yeah, got it. Along those creases.
Now if you want to take that.
Sure.
The next step.
Sorry. Just a bandana. It's fine.
Using your free hand, fold the bandana along the creases and drop it into the folds of the makeshift
bag. Just drop it in.
Just
drop
put it in. Yeah.
Okay, fine.
Put it in. There you
drop
go.
Drop it in there. It's fine.
Okay. And it says from the outside of the side of the bag, just to make sure it's there, just squeeze underneath, make sure it's...
Squeeze it. Okay. Yeah, it's fine. It's fine. Yeah. It's going well, Tom.
No.
what's happened, Tom? I've done exactly what you said. To the letter. What's
I've just turned the page, you've done that a bit quickly.
But Tom, I'm quick.
But
that's the thing.
It says what the audience didn't see was that you never actually put it in there.
But I put it in, Tom. Like, I put it in like you told me to. Following instructions.
This really... we're really going to have to try and sort this out.
We're magicians, Tom. Let's sort it out. Come on.
Okay, tell you what. We'll get rid of those, they're useless. I think we're really going to have to hope for the best here. So, what I'm going to do is ask everyone to count down from three when I say, and on one, you're just going to have to open that and hope the bandana disappears.
Let's hope.
That's okay.
Let's hope so.
Everyone ready? So, three, two, one, go!
Go!
Oh.
After a 3-0 victory in the first round, he'll be feeling confident of progressing to the final. Please welcome back Mr. Witts. It's Mr. Wilkes!
All I hear in my head right now, I was crushed.
For our last piece of entertainment, before the final match, we've invited two of senior management's finest to have an ultimate showdown. The man who knows everything about any university, bringing hope even to the lower six, and determined to emerge victorious, it's Mr. Dunstan!
Mr. Dunstan!
Right, so it is now time
for our final fight of the day. You've already seen him fight before. Surprisingly, he's the more mature of the two competitors. Who saw that one coming? It's Mr. Wilkes! In this first of five final. The second finalist, a rookie in the ring, but he's blown away the competition. He's the little teapot with big ambitions. Please give it up for Mr. Castle.
Come back again.
I'm always going to be back there, sir, for more. You can't
go down there to the case or not, my words.
Thank you very much, everyone. You're two finalists and your champion.
Three, two, one.
Go!
Oh, sorry, starting?
Yeah. Yeah. I don't mind either way.
Let's keep the hat on.
Find a way to make, find a solution. Maybe not the best solution.
Just piling people up in random places.
I'm building a wall. It's called Adrian's Wall.
Oh, hey, Will, did I ever get to talk to you about the first year Fight Club sketch?
Oh, yeah, yeah, great sketch. I mean, it'd be so funny. Imagine if the first year Fight Club actually existed. Which of course, it doesn't.
Yes, the first year Fight Club doesn't exist.
Eddie, are you saying the first year Fight Club actually does exist?
Well, no, because that'd be bad, wouldn't it? I thought it wouldn't. Of course not. Right?
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Fine.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Right.
Great.
Yeah.
Okay.
Fine.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Good.
Yeah. Carrie, I've got something to tell you. When, you know about how they make great art. To make an omelette, you've got to break a few eggs.
What the hell do you mean by that?
Well, bones, really. Quite a lot of bones.
Oh my God, this can't get any worse.
Well, that's the thing, really. Because there's another thing I need to discuss with you.